the feminist movement, the LGBTIQ movement, as stronger than ever. We need to celebrate it, and we need to keep fighting for our rights.
I've always been a feminist, even since I was a baby.
And no one can tell you what you're able to do or not.
It has to get better.
I'm a bit emotional today. It's a huge responsibility being here, raise their voice for the woman, cannot be here. So we can do it, so we have to.
As a woman with a disability, I'm deeply aware how the different aspects of my identity intersect and impact my daily life. But I also know that I'm not alone. There are countless others who face multiple forms of discrimination and marginalization, just like me. That's why I came to defend our rights at the United Nations Commission on the Status of Women. I had the chance to connect with some truly remarkable activists, both in New York and Washington. Their stories and power left me truly moved and inspired.
See that this priority theme this year on the digital, yeah, it really covers all the areas that we are working on in gender equality. It's the question of gender-based violence in there. It's the question of employment, the digital gender gap, the digital pay gap, the pension gap. Yeah. So every topic, even also climate and the supply chains, and access to technology, we have all in there. Very important that we are here, as Greens especially. Yes.
What is the role of women and girls in the Kenyan election and then in Africa as a whole? How can women and girls be at the forefront of some of the innovations and technologies? Women have been innovating. Our moms have been innovating. Our grandmas have been innovating, and not necessarily digital technologies, but different innovations we use every single day. We need to continue documenting those innovations so that they can also be recognized as part and parcel of women's contributions to digital and gender equality. Hope for me means that the world understands that we are not different and we should all strive to ensure that everyone gets an equal opportunity. You know, if you look at the politics of the global north and the global majority, we need to connect. We really need to connect with those who have not been able to reach where we are at and to give them a decent living.
It's amazing how much strength you get from people who fight the same battle. Recognizing and addressing the intersections of inequality is the only way for building a more inclusive and equitable society. Therefore, I couldn't come to the US without meeting GLAAD. For over 30 years, GLAAD has been at the forefront of cultural change in the US. Accelerating acceptance for the LGBTIQ community through entertainment, news, digital media, and much more.
We are not a legal organization. We're not a policy organization, which always gets very interesting interacting with policy government people because we sort of work in a very, I think, very differently. I think about influence. I think about who can get people to do something, how we get in front of them, what sort of messages can go across. And then there is always the legal policy side of that as well, which is necessary. And so it kind of makes a pretty good partnership for us. People that consume media, film, television, even advertising with LGBTQ content actually makes them more aware of LGBTQ people, makes them feel like they have a better understanding of LGBTQ people. They feel less confused about language and terminology. Strange World is a Disney animated film. We have been pushing Disney for a long time for inclusion. This is the most explicit inclusion. I think a lot about influence. Who can say something that will have people re-examine, rethink what they are saying, what they are doing? Do those words have impact? I do think
in the last 10 years, there's tried to be a much more intentional effort toward recognizing and working toward intersectional liberation, knowing these things are very tied in together. Intentional effort to say it does not work unless there's wider inclusion, or for us, even representation.
Meeting these amazing human rights advocates made me reflect on my own story of how I became who I am today.
We are still struggling with the same issues, being invisible. No one with disabilities in the media, or we do have a few in politics, and that's it. My parents were great. I'm from a little village, very conservative. Then, of course, the question, which school is she able to write? And my mom was like, she can paint pictures, so she's able to hold a pen and to do it. Oh, she would never ever do this, or she will never ever achieve that without knowing me. What can we do? What can we do with you? Like, in which box can we put you? So when I was a teenager, really hard to which group I'm supposed to be. I'm part of. Where's my place? No one can tell you what you're able to do or not.
All of this progress cannot be taken away from us. We cannot go backwards. This is why I also wanted to meet with leading feminists in Washington, D.C., who are fighting for sexual and reproductive rights on health in the U.S. and globally.
I see access to sexual and reproductive health services as a mental health issue, as a family health issue. My mother went to a Catholic university and she met my father and she was 18. And of course, they weren't allowed to have sex because they weren't married. But there was all this sexual tension, so they got married when she was 18. And then my dad cheated on her from the very beginning. And she had 5 children in 6 years. They moved to Los Angeles. It was 1960s. She didn't know anybody and she had no support. And the church told her, literally, you married him, you made your bed, you have to lie in it. And she had a mental breakdown. And she ultimately lost custody of all of us, and my father raised us. And so I keep going because just in the space of one lifetime, from my mother to me, it's that different. And I know it's terrible, and I know terrible things keep happening, but my daughter is 23, and I want her to have every chance in the world. And so I can't stop because it has to get better.
Women, the LGBTIQ community, and persons with disabilities are changing the world. Together, we can build a world where everyone has the opportunity to reach their full potential, regardless of their gender identity, expression, sexual orientation, or ability.
As long as generations change, but our struggle stays the same, I will be a feminist.